Hi guys, Kirk here with Kirk on Plastering. Today what I'm going to do is explain how we correct this foundation. A little bit more work involved than it looks. Number one, I'm going to pressure wash, and I got three pressure washers. This is my big one. It's got 3000 PSI, which means it's very powerful, because all this dirt, moss, and crap like that, I want it off. Our plaster won't adhere to any finishes that aren't perfectly clean. Jackhammer there. I'm gonna jackhammer all of this stuff off because they're landscaping and they want this to go down clean. And we're going all the way around the entire perimeter of the house. So there's quite a bit here. After I jackhammer everything off, then we gotta apply a bonding agent. That Hudson sprayer right there, I'm gonna put a gallon of Weldcrete in there. And rather than brush all this, I'm going to use the Hudson sprayer, just spray the bonding agent on it. Then when we come to do the plaster, now you might have noticed, this stucco here, it's about 1 inch to 6 inches thick in some spots. Now, we're going to be using a product called Rapid Set. Now Rapid Set, if you went to their website, there's a fella who's applying this product, and he's putting it on 6 inches thick, coat after coat after coat. I've said before, why would anybody want to go 6 inches thick? Well, here's a perfect example of why somebody would want to go 6 inches thick. After we get this prepped properly, I'm going to apply coat after coat after coat to build it out in areas where needed. Then I'm going to actually put a skip trowel finish on it like this to match it. So I'm only going to highlight this one side right here because I'll bore the crap out of you guys going around the entire house. And keep in mind too, when you're going to do something like this, this is not just 4 or 5 buckets. This is 2 bags of stucco, which is the equivalent 100 pound bags. They're 94 technically. And I'm going to have to mix that stuff with 600 pounds of sand. So I've got my big diesel truck here. It's a utility truck. And I got my brother with a mixer. So just letting you know, there's a little bit more involved than just trying to mix it in buckets. You need a mixer, you need the equipment, and you need the ability to know how to do this. A fella emailed me and says, why are you showing everybody the tricks of the trade? What I do is highlight our skills. This is what stucco contractors, plastering contractors, this is what we do. So I'm highlighting our work ethics. I'm not doing this to show a homeowner how to. You can look at it, but I've known guys 4 or 5 years who are in the trade, simply can't do what we're about to do. So don't be misled by, hey, gee, I can do like Kirk. You can't unless you've got time in. Anyway, we're going to get started here. I'm going to get my pressure washer on and start pressure washing all this. And we're going to jackhammer it and get busy. When we get to do the cement work, I'll show you that part too, because that's somewhat interesting, where you go coat after coat after coat. And again, even to do that particular material, you have to be certified. And you have to know how to mix it. My brother's been mixing this stuff for years. He's an expert. So I'll show you that part too, because it's kind of interesting.
Weldcrete, that's a bonding agent. Without that bonding agent going on top of the foundation as well as the house, we'll have issues, and plus we're spraying it underneath too.
Okay guys, I've already applied a couple buckets, or a couple wheelbarrows actually, here and there. Now this product, again, it's so thick. I like that fellow on YouTube who works for the company. He is going coat after coat after coat. What I'm doing is the same thing. I'm going to go around the house about 4 times, and each time I go, this stuff will set. This stuff sets in like 15-20 minutes, and it gets hard. It has a PSI, I think it's like 3,000 PSI. It's almost as hard as concrete, and it's stuck. So we're going coat after coat. I'll show you when we get to an area where I've already This is just a scratch coat right here, basically. All right, guys. I think we're on bag three. And what I'm doing is I'm putting another coat. This is frost, well, a couple coats here already. And I'm just gonna keep doing this right here. What I'm doing is I'm filling this top up. And this is already set. That's a little while ago. But this stuff sets very fast. That's why you gotta be certified to use it. And there have been guys who mix this up in a mixer, take lunch, they lose that mixer because this sets fast. And when it sets, it's very, very strong. So I kind of enjoy doing this stuff here. There's a lot of ways to do it. All right, guys. Jay and I are putting on a final coat. We've got several coats here. This particular product, again, not for everybody. It generally costs about anywhere between $30 to $40 with tax per bag, and we're on, I think, our third bag right now. So, kind of get what you pay for. We are going to get ready to float this, and when we're floating it, I'm going to be pulling it upward, and then I'm going to texture it. Getting ready to go on the side over here. I'll show you the texture part too. And before I complete with this video, we'll take you to the front of the house and show you what it looks like also. Okay guys, what I'm doing here is I've pyramided these bottoms, meaning just like a pyramid, so I can scrape that. I'll scrape back just like that because I have to get this wall true and plugged for my texture. We do that. And I'll show you something else we do. After we get it to the plumb, my joint, I'm going to use this hard rubber float. Now the hard rubber float, it gets the joint real well in here. And that's not the completion either. After we get the joint, I'm going to wet this sponge float here. As I wet this sponge float, I'm going to come upward like this, and then I will be ready to do my texture. When I'm done with the texture, I'll walk you around to the front and this side. The front was twice as bad as this. Okay guys, we are almost done with this guy. What I'm doing now is just put the texture on. Kind of look at what they have here and match it. There's 100 different textures somebody can do. What they've got is going upward. Then we get our joint in too. Because theirs has been painted so many times and it's somewhat flat, after I get my texture on, now I'm gonna flatten it out. And that way, when they paint this one, pretty close. We're doing a lot of textures. We've done heavy ones like Taco Bell and lightly Spanish. This one is kind of in between. Follow me around and I'll show you what we've done. All right. Right here. Got all this done. And in the front, I'll show you the last piece. Hey Brad.
Hey.
There's Brad. BR Concrete. Brad's getting ready to do the
concrete.
He's getting ready to do all the concrete around here and we're just prettying it up for Brad.
Yeah, that looks good.
Anyway, nice. This is Kirk with Kirk Giordano Plastering. Thank you folks for watching. We'll see you guys on the next one.